Hey, what's going on, everybody? Thomas here, and this is Buffalo Fanatics. In this video, I'm coming at you guys with a question. Can the Buffalo Bills repeat their 2014 season on defense and have a top three defense in the NFL for the 2018 NFL season? Let's go. So obviously I don't mean a repeat of the 2014 season. I'm really just saying, can they have a cold front 2.0? Can it come back to life? Can they have an elite, truly an elite defense? Legion of Boom in Buffalo. That's what I'm saying. What can they have in the 2018 NFL season? Let's find out. So obviously I'm going to start with the contracts. So we got Star Lotulelei at a 5-year deal. We got Micah Hyde at a 4-year deal. We got Jordan Poyer, Matt Milano, Tre'Davious White, and our newly signed amazing player, Trent Murphy, to 3 more years on the Buffalo Bills roster. We also have Shaq Lawson and Jerry Hughes for 2 more years, and we have Vontae Davis and Lorenzo Alexander for 1 more year. So what does that mean? It means pretty much our defense is pretty much set for at least the next year, 2 years, 3 years. So whatever happens with that, if they play good, we might have a really good defense for the next coming years. Now, what do the Buffalo Bills really, truly need to upgrade on that defense to make it an elite defense? Linebackers. Outside linebacker. What's going to happen with Lorenzo Alexander after his deal is up? Are they going to re-sign him? Most likely not. Reason being, he's an edge rusher. He fits best in a 3-4 defense. We saw that in 2016. We saw how dominant he was when he was on the outside, right on the line, rushing the passer. Amazing pass rusher. However, he lacks at linebacker. Watch the film of Zoe at outside linebacker and tell me what you think. He's a little old. We need a younger player there. So what else? Preston Brown signs a 1-year contract with the Cincinnati Bengals. He's going back to his hometown. Can't hate him. He didn't sign with the Patriots. That's all that matters. EJ Gaines is expected today. If it doesn't happen today, it's happening soon. He's expected to sign a contract with the Cleveland Browns. So he's gone. Leonard Johnson. What are we going to do with Leonard Johnson? Is he going to stay? Is he going to go? I actually wouldn't mind retaining him. He was probably the most underrated player on defense last year. So I'm going to break down some stats to basically give you guys an idea of what the Buffalo Bills need to do, how they need to improve to become that elite defense once again like they had in 2014. So the Buffalo Bills tied for 6th place with interceptions. They had 18 total interceptions and 2 defensive touchdowns. The NFL league average was 13.5 interceptions per team. Fantastic job of taking the ball away. Fantastic. And the average defensive touchdowns was 2.71. Need to up that. Next up, we got sacks. The Buffalo Bills were horrible with sacks. They had 27 sacks, and the league average is 35.8 sacks. Gotta upgrade that pass rush, for sure. Gotta get some players there. And I think with Trent Murphy, Star Lotulelei, Kyle Williams, and Jerry Hughes, plus the rotation in with Shaq Lawson and Ryan Davis, Eddie Yarborough, those guys, it's gonna be a pretty nice defensive line, if you ask me. So the Buffalo Bills will probably have a higher number of sacks, so we can look forward to that. So now moving on to points given up. The Buffalo Bills gave up 359 points for the entire season. The league average was 347.5. So they need to limit those touchdowns given up. When you face Tom Brady twice a year, it's kind of hard to do. Let's just be honest. It's kind of hard to do. However, they need to get better at that. Moving on, we have touchdowns given up. The Buffalo Bills gave up 38 total touchdowns this year, and the league average is 38.2 touchdowns given up. So pretty much you're in the middle of the pack there. Now moving on, fumbles. The Buffalo Bills were fantastic at turnovers. We can all see it when we go back to look at the games and look at the highlights. The Buffalo Bills had 25 fumbles this year on defense, and the league average is 20, so fantastic. You're above the average, perfect. Gotta repeat that if you wanna be an elite defense in 2018. So the Buffalo Bills gave up 355.1 yards per game, and the league average was 334.1. Gotta make sure that the teams that come onto the field immediately go 3 and out. You can't let them gain yards on you. That's just gonna kill you in the field position game. And if you wanna be an elite defense, you have to stop those offenses from driving down the field. So moving on to first downs given up per game. They gave up 21.8 first downs per game. The league average was 19.25. Gotta limit those first downs, for sure. It goes back to the, you can't let the opposing offense drive down the field on you. That, you're not gonna get respect that way. And the Buffalo Bills came 28th in the amount of penalties at 97, and the league average was 106.8. Fifth best. Now that's fantastic. Limit those penalties. So moving on, I'm going to talk about how the Buffalo Bills can actually succeed in 2018 on defense and become that top three elite defense that everybody is scared to face. So number one, the Buffalo Bills have to repeat exactly what they did in 2017 with the turnover battle. You gotta win the turnover battle. You can't let a quarterback come in to Buffalo or on the road, score 5 touchdowns on you without giving up some picks or fumbles or whatever. You gotta turn the ball over. That is key, and that's how great defenses are born, and that's how they succeed in the NFL. Next up, you gotta get after the quarterback. Without sacking or hurrying the quarterback and making him throw the ball away or lose yardage, you're not gonna be an elite defense. You gotta make sure that you put that fear right into the quarterback's eyes and say, I can't stay in the pocket more than 2 seconds without getting crushed by Jerry Hughes, without getting smacked up by Star Latulule. That's what I'm saying. Trent Murphy coming in off the edge hot. You gotta have those guys strike fear into the quarterback's eyes and say, I can't stand in this pocket. It's not gonna be clean as soon as I snap the ball. That's what I'm saying. You don't really necessarily get that with a 4-3 unless you have some monster players, which I think the Buffalo Bills can really have a great defensive line. They just gotta work hard and get after the quarterback. Third, I think the Buffalo Bills must stop the yards per game. It's hard to do that when you're facing Tom Brady 2 times a year, but you gotta limit those yards given up. You gotta find a way to swat that ball out of the air. You gotta find a way to pick the ball off, do something to stop the quarterback from driving down the field on you. That is so key and so important. Stop him from picking up those first downs. Very important if you wanna be an elite defense. And lastly, I think the number one thing that the Buffalo Bills must do to solidify an elite defense in the NFL in 2018 is they must draft a linebacker, a middle linebacker, an outside linebacker. Who's gonna fill that Zoe spot, right? Gotta get a replacement for him, and we're limited at linebackers. So expect the Buffalo Bills to draft or go into free agency. I would like to have Will Compton. He seems like he would be a great fit in Buffalo, but you know, it is what it is, and hopefully we're gonna draft a few guys. So that's gonna do it for me, everybody. If you guys enjoyed this video, please go give a big thumbs up down below. Comment your opinions. Let me know exactly what you guys are thinking. Do you disagree with me? Do you agree with me? Let me know in the comments below. What else do the Buffalo Bills have to do in order to have an elite defense? To have that 2014 season on defense? What do the Buffalo Bills have to do? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you guys haven't done it already, please go subscribe to the channel for more amazing content and click the bell to notify you every single time we have another video so you never miss another upload. That's gonna do it for me, everybody. I hope you guys have a fantastic day wherever you're watching this from, and go Bills. I'll see you next time. Peace!